Is still online, we're calm, everything happening here. I think it's more, I'll say, like a subdued air in the city. People are going about their businesses, not as they would have, I'm sure, today, but everybody's adjusting to news of the postponement and also trying as much as possible to do something with the day. Now, I have here with me the Commissioner of Information and a Strategy for Adamawa State. He's going to just to talk to us about what is happening. Good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon, Larry. It's been a shock. Just the right word is it's been a shock. We're shocked. We are really, really, really devastated because we are prepared fully. I was in the Situation Room. I was managing the Situation Room. And we had access to information from all the local governments. We were tracking the distribution of materials. We were talking to people on ground, and we were talking to people at INEC office when we suddenly heard that the elections would be had been postponed. And we're still yet to grapple with it.
Okay, well, we would like to understand right now, can you confirm if news had gone round? What's happening in some of the inner cities, inner towns and villages in Adamawa?
I think the news has gone round, and you know, this is one very, very interesting Saturday for everybody. There will be no parties, there will be no burials, there will be no weddings, there will be no naming ceremonies. Everybody had cancelled every activity preparing for elections, and now there is no elections. So, the most important thing for us, those of us in authority, those of us in government, the most responsible thing we will need to do, and we have already started in Adamawa State, is to continuously appeal to our people, plead with them for their understanding, tell them, don't Allah kweha kurima binu, and all that we could tell them, because of course, definitely, you know, somebody who had left whatever he was doing to go back to the place where he registered, which could be a little bit far away from where he normally resides, It's quite a very terrible occurrence for the person. So we're trying to persuade our people. And we're also looking ahead, how do we contain a situation where this thing does not result in voter apathy, where it does not result in serious drop in number of people that will be willing to come out and cast their votes on the dates that have been decided. And we're also looking at the Colorado effect. We've stopped people from going to their markets this today and other economic activities. How much of it will result in drop in actual income? And we've looked at people who came from afar, the observers, national and international, who have come here, people like you, who came to cover this election. You have come here at a cost. And then what happens to all this cost?
Okay, but more importantly, a lot of people will be wondering, you know, just before even this day and all that, we'd had problems in some states as regards materials, the issue of safety of those materials at some of these offices around the country. I'm talking of INEC right now. Yeah. Now, what as a state government, what assurances can you give since some of these materials, the sensitive materials, have already left to the local government?
No, you know, we have a very little role to play as a government, but you know, if we are to suggest, if we are to decide, if we are to ask, to give an advice, you know, most of the sensitive materials that have already been exposed are automatically expired. They can't be used again because they are already materials that have been compromised, whichever way you look at it. So as a government, our advice will be that the INEC must find whatever magic they're going to play to ensure that out of their contingency, probably there would have been a by-election, whatever source they can get money, to redo some of these sensitive materials because they have been compromised. We're thinking of, along that line. But most importantly, it is now that people like us who are in the media, people like us who are in government also, it's our turn now to come out forcefully and begin to assuage the feelings of the people, to re-engineer and reinvigorate the faith of the people in the electoral process. Because, you know, this is not a failure of just INEC. It's a failure of us as a nation. We've been unable to create enduring institutions that can withstand shocks like this? At what point did the crisis precipitate? Is it a sudden crisis? Is it a festering crisis that we've ignored? We need to study all of these things, and we have only 1 week. And that is the danger in it. Okay. We have only 1 week.
All right, there you have it, the Commissioner of Information and Strategy here in Adamawa State, talking about some of the steps that can be taken, making suggestions also as regards the way forward from this point that I'm sure has caught everybody unawares. A lot of us were still looking at whether it will happen, it won't happen. Well, it happened. We'll still be here on ground monitoring situations here in Adamawa State.